Good morning, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com. Today is the 24th of July, 2024. It's a Wednesday. We just had the release of the Bank of Canada's interest rate decision. So here are the key things you need to know for today's U.S. session. The Bank of Canada did cut interest rates as widely expected down to the 4.5% level. And accompanying that interest rate cut, the central bank also released a relatively dovish statement emphasizing that downside risks are taking on increasing prominence in how it's evaluating the economy, and that it is reasonable to expect further interest rate cuts as the year goes on. Overall, that's leading to a rise in the US dollar versus the Canadian dollar, as we'll see on the next slide. Some of the other relevant news to know: Eurozone PMIs missed expectations, showing a contraction in manufacturing PMI at 45.6, slight growth in services PMI at 51.9 across the channel. The PMI figures were slightly stronger in the UK at 51.8 and 52.4. And then looking to stocks, the NASDAQ 100 is trading down about 1.5% at the open. We saw disappointing earnings results, I would say, especially from Tesla and to a lesser extent from Google. Google's results were mostly as expected, though there were some concerns about YouTube's ad revenue and perhaps the risk of overinvesting in AI. As a result, those two magnificent seven stocks are weighing on the NASDAQ 100, lending a bit of a risk-off vibe to today's trade. As promised, here's a chart of the US dollar versus the Canadian dollar, in this case, a zoomed out four-hour chart where we can see dollar CAD's been on an absolute tear over the last week plus, moving from near 136 all the way up to about 138 as I'm speaking to you now. In the short term, the key level to watch is around 137.80. That was a key level of previous resistance or a ceiling on price. We've now broken above it, so it should provide, and indeed is providing, support or a floor under prices, at least so far in today's session. If dollar CAD holds on to its gains and perhaps even extends them as we come into the Bank of Canada press conference at 10:30 Eastern time, there's room to rally further in the coming days toward that multi-month high up closer to 138.50. So overall, as long as we hold that 37.80 level, the near-term outlook for dollar CAD remains bullish in my view. That is today's video. Thank you for carving some time out of your day to watch. And whether you're catching us on Twitter or YouTube, please do like this video. Give me a follow, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's a great way to support us as we continue to produce more of these videos moving forward. Thanks and best of luck with your trading.